Good afternoon, friends. Welcome to our channel, Global Online University. Today in this video, I am going to talk about the important topics in physical chemistry and the related books. So, the first topic is chemical kinetics. This is a very important chapter. It carries a lot of marks in the exam. So, what you need to focus in kinetics, that I will tell you. The main thing you have to focus in kinetics are the zero order reaction, the first order, the second order, the nth order reactions, and the related plots. The related plots are very important. So make sure after reading all these things, practice the first order, second order, and zeroth order plots. The concentration versus time plot. Next is the complex reactions, like the reversible reactions or opposing reaction, parallel reaction, consecutive reaction. So these three you have to read accurately, means you have to study this. Then is the transition state theory. So in transition state theory, you have to read the delta H, delta G, delta S value of the transition state. Then comes the temperature dependence of reaction rate, that is the Arrhenius equation. Then we need to study the collision theory, which is not so important but little bit important, and this is the important part. Every alternate net question comes from this topic, that is enzyme catalysis and the related plots like line over bar plot, eddy half strip plot, like that. Then theory of unimolecular reaction, which is also known as Lindemann equation. So these are the things you have to study from chemical kinetics. So in the last video, I told you to maintain a formula book. So in this chapter also, whenever you will read this chapter, just maintain a formula book. Next comes adsorption. This is one of the important chapter, but not so many marks comes from this chapter, but still you have to read. This is a very easy chapter. It will take hardly 2 to 3 hours. If you study 2 to 3 hours, you will get a clear idea about this chapter. And in this chapter, what you have to read is the factors affecting adsorption. What are the factors affecting adsorption, like the temperature, pressure, nature of the adsorbate, nature of the adsorbent, etc. Then you have to study the Freundlich isotherm, then Langmuir isotherm. This is the important part. Langmuir isotherm, like dissociative as well as non-dissociative. Dissociative means in case of ozone or like this, and non-dissociative molecules you have to study also. Then the Bethe isotherm and then Gibbs isotherm. So these are the things you have to read in adsorption. And other things you can just take a look, like emulsion, salt, aerosol, gel, like that. Just take a look of those. Okay, next is the solid state, which is again another important chapter in physical chemistry. In solid state, you have to read all the seven crystal system, all the seven crystal system, and the relation between A, B, C, the edge length, and the relation between the alpha, beta, gamma. This is all relation for monoclinic, triclinic, rhombohedral, tetragonal, cubic, everything you have to just memorize. And then important is Bragg's equation. You have to memorize this Bragg's equation. That's A to N lambda is 2D sin theta. From there, DH scale, we have a formula of DH scale. Then you have to study the HKL value for BCC, primitive, as well as face center cubic lattices. And then Miller indices. Then you have to study octahedral as well as tetrahedral voids. Then the atomic radii of the relation between A and atomic radii and edge length. Like for primitive, it's A equal to 2R. For BCC, it's 4R equal to root 3A. And for FCC, it's 4R equal to root 2A. Like that, this all atomic radii you have to learn. And then the radius ratio, that's R plus, R cation by R anion. That ratio you have to learn. Then the one density formula is there. Rho is equal to Zm by A cube Na, which is an important formula. Then you have to read the structure of the crystal system for sodium chloride, for cesium chloride, for fluoride structure, calcium fluoride, antifluoride structure, Na2O, woodsite, like that, etc. So I will tell everything in details afterwards. Then the defects in crystal system. Okay, so Frenkel defect, Schottky defect, F-center, everything. Then semiconductor, N-type, P-type semiconductor, doping, etc. And spinel, inverse spinel, and mixed spinel. That's all for solid state. So let's move to thermodynamics, which is again a very important chapter in every competitive exam. Thermodynamics, what you have to read. If you have a clear idea of first law and second law, no need to read the first law again. Just try to recap all the formulas. Just write it down in a notebook. Just try to recap all the formulas. The important thing in thermodynamics is the Maxwell relation. So all the relation of Maxwell, and there is some shortcut tricks that I will share with you later. And Joule experiment, you know, is an isoenergetic expansion. Then Joule-Thomson experiment, which is a isoenthalpic expansion like that. And from there, you will get the value of mu jt, the coefficient values. And then Carnot engine, just to read. Then refrigerators, numerical problems. And different reversible and irreversible processes, like reversible isothermal process, reversible adiabatic process, everything this we have to write. And the respective WQ is work done, heat absorbed or evolved, delta U value, delta S value, delta H value, everything. Then the KP, KC, KX, the relation among those, you have to read this thing. Next come the phase equilibria. Generally in phase equilibria, question comes from degrees of freedom, either from degrees of freedom or from Clausius-Clapeyron equation or some enthalpy, entropy or free energy of mixing. This type of questions come. And another thing comes is the phase diagram of carbon dioxide and water as well as the sulfur. So I will make a video on phase equilibria afterwards, which will contain these topics. Next is the colligative property. So this chapter is very easy, I think, because in class 12 standard, this chapter is there. So you might have studied this chapter earlier. So I think you have a clear idea of this chapter. So just try to remember the formulas. But that's all. Nothing more. Like lowering of vapor pressure, then elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, osmotic pressure, and the abnormal behavior, that is Van't Hoff equation. That is it. One thing I forgot to tell you, that is that in thermodynamics, plots are very important. Each and every plots, H versus T, like H versus T, the dependence of specific heat with temperature, this type of plots are very important. So just look at those. And next is conductance and electrochemistry. Generally question comes from this chapter, lots of questions. Lots means specific quantity of question comes from this chapter. So in conductance, you have to study the conductance, equivalent conductance, Kohlrush law, then the equivalent conductivity for sparingly soluble salt like AgCl. Then we have to read the activity as well as the activity coefficient, that is the gamma value, that thing. Then conductivity titration, like strong acid versus strong base, weak acid versus strong acid versus weak base, then precipitation reaction. Then Nernst equation, this is also you learned it in class 12. Then glass electrode, Calomel electrode, Quinn hydrogen electron, everything. Then the delta G, delta H, delta S value, then the KSP values. Then potentiometric titration, this is an important thing, potentiometric titration. Then concentration cell, we have to read, like with liquid junction potential as well as without liquid junction potential. So what will the formula? Basically you have to read the formulas and some concepts. And then transport number, that's T plus, T minus, what is the relation between T plus and U plus, ionic mobility, these things. And next is ionic equilibria. This is also a chapter which is important in every competitive exam. One or two questions may come from this chapter. Like you have to calculate the pH if you are given, say, 10 to the power minus 8 molar HCl. Let's calculate the pH. This. Then the buffer thing, Henderson equation. Then hydrolysis of salts. So salts of weak acid and strong base, salts of weak base and strong acid, like this. And then the acid base titration. Next, in spectroscopy, we will mainly focus on rotational spectroscopy, then the selection rules, all the selection rules, and then spectrum of rigid rotator as well as non-rigid rotator. Then we'll move to IR spectroscopy, then simple harmonic oscillator, anharmonic oscillator, then Raman, then electronic transitions. So we will do the theory concept as well as some numericals based on this topic. So this is very important chapter. Spectroscopy is important in NET, GATE, all exam is very important. Next is quantum, another important and the toughest I think in physical chemistry. So if you like quantum, then it's good. But if you feel difficult in quantum or uncomfortable, then I will suggest you to start with quantum. Okay. So in quantum, what is there? Particle in box problem. So 1D, 2D, 3D. Then particle in ring. Then probability. Then expectation values. Then commutator, perturbation, variation theorem. Then wave function plots, all the wave function plots. Then in group theory, we will learn the character table related problems, point group and symmetry, as well as all the symmetry operations. Next comes the gaseous state. In gaseous state, we will study the most probable velocity, the RMS velocity, the average velocity, and the CpCv values for the linear and non-linear molecules. And this chapter, just no need to read so much. It will take 32 to 3 hours to study this chapter. Just we will study the Mn value, the formulas, Mw, Mv, then the chain length of a polymer, then the Kmr, the probability of link of polymer, and then we will know the different experimental methods to get the Mn, Mw, and Mv value, like sedimentation method, light scattering method, osmotic pressure method. These are all, these are the topics which you need to focus mainly for CS and NET exam. And now I will tell you some important books which you should follow. So first thing I will tell you to follow this, if you have this book, or you will, I think you will get some PDF in online. So this is a book which is written by Atkins. This is Peter Atkins, Physical Chemistry by Peter Atkins. This is a very good book. You should follow this book. And then, so in Peter Atkins, you will get each and everything. For kinetics, everything you will get. And then from spacing, for spectroscopy, only for spectroscopy, I will suggest you to strictly follow this book. This Fundamentals of Molecular Spectroscopy by Banwell. Fundamentals of Molecular Spectroscopy by Banwell. This is a very good book. I will suggest you, you should follow this. You must follow this book. And for quantum chemistry, if you want to follow, then you can follow this book. This is a very good book in quantum chemistry. And this is a very popular book. You can ask everybody, every friend or teachers, you can ask about this book. It's Quantum Chemistry by Donald McCurry. It's a very important book. And another book I will suggest you, I will suggest this book. This book is very good. This also contains all the chapters of physical, all the concepts of physical. And this book is like a comparative approach book. And this is Principles of Physical Chemistry. Principles of Physical Chemistry. It's an Indian writer book, Puri Sharma Pathania. This book is very good. You can refer this book also. So that's all for this video. So if you like my video, then please like, share, and also subscribe our channel. Thank you.